Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of another day in the world of Minecraft as that scaly over there burns up, the zombie burns up, and the spiders just have a little fun heyday. Speaking of spiders, there's a spider that's trapped in my garbage can in my bathroom. I thought I killed it, but it like resurrected itself like Jesus, and it's back. It's still crawling around in the bottom, and you know what? If he fought that much, I'm just gonna let him live down there. And he can make it his little home until he dies, and gets thrown out in the garbage if he lives that long, and then he can, I'm trying to equate this to a movie, like, if you fight long enough for your survival, you know what, you can survive. Maybe it's like that gamer movie, that's kind of weird, but you know where the gamer, and there's, I don't know, there's weird surrogates, and you'd fight as a person, you'd fight as a criminal, and I don't know, that's just weird. I'm just going on a weird tangent. So today we're going to continue building our house. And we're building it inside of that cliff over there. So we're just going to make sure I grab some supplies. And save the world so I don't lose my stuff. Got to keep remembering to do that because Minecraft keeps crashing. So I believe if I just save it all, I'll be fine. There's a nice little spider over there. But they don't... Do they even hurt you in the day? Like, can you touch them and they won't hurt you? I think that's what I learned yesterday. Yeah, you can, like, jump on them, ride them. You can't jump on them. It doesn't let you jump on them. But they don't hurt you during the day. I did not know that. I thought they just didn't attack you during the day. But, yeah, last video I was talking about, I'm kind of just continuing my college experience and my A-minuses of doom. Yes, they're A-minuses of doom now. They're that bad. But my second A-minus I had my first term, have not had an A-minus since, was in public speaking, Comm 111. I was bomb in that class. Not like bombing it, like I was bomb. I was like the bomb. Like, you wouldn't even know like how good I was at that class. Everyone loved my speeches. That like, there was consensus among the class that my speeches were the best. Yet I consistently got A minuses on them. I would get A's on the test. I'd be like the only kid to be able to get an A on the test. The rest of the kids would be like, that test was so hard. I got a D minus. You got a D minus. I got an F plus. but yeah, it was like the test was that bad. And I did good on it. I didn't really study. I didn't even open my book. We were required to buy this book and like this database access key thing. I never even opened that. I just gave it to my friend this term to use, and he's actually using it, but I don't know, it was... Hey, buddy. Yeah, get out of here and die. Get out of my house. Jerk. Oh, you're cheap. You're in water. I don't have any arrows. Crap, get out of my way. He's dead? Nope, he's still there. Got him. Okay, wow. But yeah, the class just seemed really easy for me, and my speeches were always right on. She always picked on my speeches for like the stupidest things ever. It's like, you didn't cite your resources correctly. It's like, well, you didn't tell me I needed to do it a certain way or not. And I always volunteered or got picked to go first in the speeches, so I couldn't get an example. She would tell us things like after I had already done my speech, and she'd grade it, and then I'd be taught things, and so it was like I was consistently getting better grades. She'd be like, whoever volunteers, I always grade more leniently. No, not at all. Not at all. She would grade mine so much harder. I just don't think she liked me. That and she's on a power trip. She's a comm major, a graduate comm major. Is like, well, maybe you're just cranky because you're still doing this comm stuff. And, but yeah, like one kid in our class managed to pull out an A, and that was because he was getting like straight on A's on his speeches. And his speeches were good, but they weren't good as mine. And everyone agreed that mine were better, mine were more motivational, mine were more informative, etc., etc. But she just always graded mine down, and I don't know how close I was to an A rather than an A minus, but it was probably like right on the boundary. But I was, my speeches were like right on the 90 percentile range, and it's really annoying. There was nothing I could do to really make them better or get my grade up, so it was just annoying. I didn't try to fight that grade because it was be hard to deal with the TA on Kool-Aid break. It'd just be hard to deal with the TA because she was on a power trip. It was obvious that she was on a power trip, and it was just, I didn't want to take the class. It's like, okay, I'll just deal with it, and I'll hit the ground running and just do my best at it. Because I feel like that's the only thing you can really do. It's just to do your best when you have to take a class that you don't want to take. When you're forced to take it. Because you have to take it. You might as well just do your best and deal with it. Get over it. Cry me a river, build me a bridge, and get the F over it, as some people say. So that river's been cried, not literally, just figuratively. And a bridge has been built. In fact, it's right there. and that's in the past. That was, a year and a half ago, I guess. Actually, that's not that far in the past, but, ever since then, it's been smooth sailing. I've had teachers that would actually listen to my suggestions, my inputs, things like that. I don't know, some teachers just don't care. Some graduate teachers, or GTA is not Grand Theft Auto, but graduate teaching assistants, just think they're better because they have that title and they're getting paid to BS through this class with you. So, I don't know. That's that. Another Kool-Aid break. Let's see if I can do it while mining successfully. Bam. So the Kool-Aid flavor for the day, for the session, is green. It is... I was actually surprised about the outcome of the color. I thought it was going to be more like the vibrant neon yellow, because it's lemon lime. And lemon lime is just generically super bright yellow, but this is actually like a dark green. And I was like, I don't know if it's because there was a little bit of red left in the jug. Like a little bit, like I poured everything out, and there's, but some stayed in it because I'm using like an Arizona tea jug. So I didn't know if it was because of that, or if it's just green, or maybe Gatorade was trying to copyright or patent the vibrant, bright yellow color. Because lemon lime Gatorade is kind of that the iconic Gatorade. It's just the bright, bright freaking yellow. Because I mean, it's the cheapest Gatorade for them to produce, and it's one of the most common. It's seen a lot in sport type events. I don't know, it's just traditional. It's when I think of Gatorade, I think of the bright, 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 like, beyond piss-colored yellow Gatorade. That's the lemon lime flavor, because that's what I grew up on. The powdered drink that was in, like, the yellow can or the orange can, and it just made this water just bright yellow. It's like, it really stood out. Wow, I'm sorry. I just belched from green Kool-Aid. But yeah, that's what I think of Gatorade. But lemon lime, I don't know. It feels like lemon lime should be brighter than this. But whatever. Gatorade has gone so far these days. It's pretty insane, like how many different flavors and varieties they have. Like they have G2, they have rain, they have normal, they have like hydrate, they have Tiger Woods, or they had Tiger Woods. I think they might have pulled that, deciding that they didn't want their fluids to be resembling Tiger Woods anymore. I don't know. That was a stretch for a joke. If you have a better Tiger Woods joke, feel free to leave it in the comments. It can, or you don't have to relate it to Gatorade. But feel free to relate it to Gatorade if you can make that stretch somehow. But other than that, your Tiger Woods jokes down in the comments. That'd be great. It's not too late to make jokes about that. I mean, I was a fan of Tiger Woods beforehand, and then I would still have been a fan afterwards if he didn't just completely start sucking at golf. Like, he was so baller at golf. He was the icon. He was like, oh, look at me, I can make a hole in one in this par six, because there's not even a par six on any golf course, but he could still make a hole in one somehow. I don't think he ever made a hole in one on a par five, but anyway, he had that kind of stigma about him. But now his stigma is completely different. I would still have respected him as a golfer, as a professional athlete, because honestly, how many like pro basketball players haven't done something like that? It's the normal almost in pro sports, it seems. It's really pathetic. But when he got all that publicity, he completely lost his composure. He went like a billion and oh and a billion. He just stopped winning things like at all. And when you stop winning things as a pro athlete, that doesn't work because you're paid to win. And he went from like the most paid athlete to the most, I don't know, unliked athlete, I guess. That doesn't really make much sense. I apologize, it doesn't make sense. But it's getting dark, or is it gonna rain? I think it's just getting dark because it's getting nighttime. I should make a bed here soon. Maybe I'll do that next episode. And then put a wall on this, and then it's beautiful to live in here, so I don't have to go back and forth all the time. So I'm just gonna get a few more blocks here. I can't dig up very well. Okay. Let's see. What else? What else? Gatorade. Lots of varieties. Yes, yes, lots of varieties. I've always been a fan of the blue Gatorades. I don't know about you guys, but I don't know if it's just the flavor or if it's like the refreshing effect or if it was just the color. My favorite color is blue. But yeah, that's my thoughts. Oh crap, I gotta get back. It's getting dark now. Hey, it's like my house is in a different time zone. Oh, not anymore. Oh, another Kool-Aid sip because I'm talking a lot. That's good stuff. That is good stuff. Hey, sheepies. Gotcha. Okay, what was that? Was that a bad guy? I don't know. At least they don't have, like, guns. They have cows. You made me break my torch. Die. Okay. Let's go to sleep. So thank you very much for watching. Please like this video. Leave it a rating, you know. The something something, the nudge nudge, wink wink, you know. If you want to favorite it, please do favorite it. That's always an option. It's always an option to share this with your friends and your contacts, as every time you do it, it really does help me out. The growth is slow here on YouTube, and I feel like it could be better. But you know what? I'm grateful for every little bit I get. Please subscribe. If you have not already subscribed, please do that. Because every subscription really does help me out. And that cow agrees with me. Right, cow? Right, cow? Oh, he's shaking his head. No, I guess he doesn't agree with me. But cow is wrong. Well, other than that, I'm going to go. I'm going to take a nap. And thank you very much. Bye.